Okay, so what is a fraction?
A fraction is a part of a whole.
There are actually two portions of a fraction. There's the numerator and also the denominator. In a fraction, the numerator and denominator tell us very important things.
All right, so what is a numerator and denominator? Let's look at a fraction right here. Before we start, here's a couple different representations of this fraction. What do you notice? What do you think the numerator is and the denominator is? All right, let's look at a model that matches this fraction. The numerator is the number of pieces that is actually represented or that we have. The denominator actually represents how many equal pieces are in a whole. Something to remember when we're talking about fractions is we are talking about equal parts. So the denominator is going to tell you how many equal parts we will have in the whole, and the numerator tells you how many equal parts you actually have. Here are multiple different representations of this fraction.
Where do we see fractions in everyday life?
Fractions are often used in measurements, when baking, when adding, subtracting. Sometimes when we're sharing, you'll think of fractions. For example, if we have a piece of pizza, we might be sharing the pizza. Or maybe we're talking about a pie and there's 12 slices in a pie. Fractions are truly all around us.
Fractions can actually be displayed in a bunch of different ways. They can be in a model, they can be on a number line, or they can actually be a part of a group. All right, I'm gonna show you a couple different models and let's see if you can name the fraction. Let's try this one.
This is a fraction model. You might notice that this is cut into pieces. When do you think you would use these models when solving a problem? There are 5 pieces there and there's 6 pieces in a whole. So our fraction is 5/6. There's 2 pieces in the picture, and there's 3 pieces in a whole, so our fraction is 2/3.